Hello Exiles, my name is Karvarousku and today I'm going to teach you how to do ship graveyard properly. You might have heard ways to navigate through ship graveyard, and the most common ones are follow the water and follow the wall. These are good rules to follow if your goal is to find either fairy graves or the entrance to ship graveyard cave. However, these are not good rules to follow when you are trying to reach the exit Cavern of Wrath with the least exploring possible. And here's a couple examples. Sometimes it's impossible to follow the water because there is none to follow, and you really have to go out of your way to find it in the first place. And the second example is that even if you can follow the water all the way, sometimes it leads you into a dead end. So how can we find the exit without exploring the whole area or running into dead ends? The exit can be in two different places. It can be inside a wall, like we have here, or it can be near the water. So on the other side of the exit there is a wall, and the other side is water. It is important to know the different types of exits, since usually within two screens from the entrance you can recognize if the exit is inside the wall or near the water. Speaking of entrances, there is four different ones. In the first one you start at the bottom left corner, second is bottom right corner, third is at the top, and the last one starts at the right side of the instance. So let's start with the last one, right side. The exit will be in the water, so you can just follow the coastline if you wish. You should not run at the edge of the water, however, but below, slightly below it, so you're able to scout monsters and chests on your way there. This is a slightly different variation of the previous instance. The goal is to get on the left side of the instance, so you can just follow the water again, but it's not necessary. The only difference between this and the previous instance was the starting point. And here we have the bottom right instance. Your goal here is to go north as much as possible until you hit the water, and then follow the water to the left until you find the exit. Here we have the third instance, the top. The exit in this layout can be either in the water or in the wall, but the general rule is the same. You go down. Usually, when you start at the top, you can't instantly tell if the exit is going to be in the water or on the wall. So you just keep going down until you either find the exit or you hit the wall. And then you just follow the wall to the left until you find the exit. And as our last entrance, we have the bottom left. This has the most variation out of all starting entrances, having exits in the water and in the wall, but also having different overall layouts. In this case, we just keep going up all the way until we see the water again, and then just follow the water until we hit the exit. In this layout, we see water connecting to the wall and it blocking our way on the left side. This is the indicator that the exit will be inside the wall, and then we just follow the wall until we see water again, and then we keep going northwest until we find the exit. In our next instance, we also hit the water on the left side of the instance, as you can see here. I call this the pipe instance because it's very similar to the last one, but without the wall. So we follow the water until we hit water on the other side, and then we keep going northwest again, just like in the previous instance. And in our last instance, we're also going to be running into water connected to wall. This is indicating that the exit will be inside the wall again. So we follow the water until we would have to make a big turn to the right, and then we just keep going north until we find the exit. I hope you enjoyed and learned something from this video. Let me know if you liked it and what instance should be covered next. Until then, have fun and bye bye!